Hello student, welcome back to our computer class. Today we are going to learn a new lesson, that is lesson number 4, working with paint. In previous lecture, means that is lesson number 3, we have learned that we have learned about MS Paint. We learn about what is MS Paint. We also learn the some features of MS Paint. We also see that how to open this MS Paint by clicking on start button, all programs, then go to Microsoft Paint and open the paint window will open. Then next we have seen the different features of the paint. We also draw with the help of that tools that we have learned in MS Paint. Now today we are going to learn how to working with paint. Again we are going to see the different features we are going to use, or tools we are going to use in this paint, MS Paint. Okay, now let's start. Now MS Paint, all of you know MS Paint. We have learned in our previous class in lesson number 3 what is MS Paint, right? With the help of MS Paint you can draw any pictures in that window, MS Paint window or paint window. Okay, even you can write using text in that. Okay, you can draw, you can color, right? All this thing you can do in MS Paint. We also seen the different tools we used in MS Paint in lesson number 3. Now today we also learning more tools in this lessons. So what is MS Paint? MS Paint is a simple graphic program. It is a simple graphic program to draw picture, is used to draw a picture. This is a simple graphic program, is used to draw a picture on the screen and color them or paint them with different colors. Okay, you just draw on MS Paint and you color it, right? With different colors are there, right? Yes. So the next is using select tools. What is select tool? Now this select tool is used to select any part of the picture that we want to change. So by using this select tool you can select any part of a picture that you want to change. Like you have drawn a house, okay, if you want to remove the roof of that house, okay, and want to modify it, you can do with the help of this select tool. For example, draw the face of Mickey Mouse. If we draw a face of Mickey Mouse using this tool, click on the rectangular selection tool. Okay, now see, click on the rectangular selection tool to select object. Place the mouse pointer just outside the area to the selected. Okay, now we will see here. After selection, see, it is shown. After select, there are selection shapes will come. Selection shapes will come, like rectangular section, free form section, select all. Okay, all these. What we have to select? We have to select the rectangular section. Okay, then click that rectangular section. Here we have seen now. So select rectangular section. Okay, just click it. Click and hold down the left mouse button. What you have to do, just after clicking it, you have to hold down that left mouse button and then drag around the outer boundary of the object where you want to make a changes. Now you have to drag around that boundary of that object. Okay, you have to drag that rectangular selection we have done. Okay, release the mouse when it is completely selected. Which part you want to change? Okay, by using this rectangular selection tool, you can just bring that by clicking and holding down the left mouse button, drag around that boundaries where you want to get changes, and you have to release the mouse button when it is completed. Now see here, that after selecting rectangular selection, we have to make a changes here, that the Mickey Mouse ear, it is not been proper. So there we have drag it. Okay, so I have to make changes here. Got it? Now use of selecting tools, and what is the use of rectangular selection tools also. If you don't want, if you want to make some changes by using the select, in that select there is a rectangular section. Okay, so by using this you can make a changes. Got it? Okay, so the next tool is using free form selection tool. So this free form selection tool is similar to the rectangular selection tool, but in the rectangular square, rectangular form will occur where it, in this free form selection tool, irregular shape will occur. For what purpose this both are used? To select the drawing, any part of a drawing, and to move that part. Okay, or we can say to cut that part from the drawing. Okay, for this purpose this both tools are used. Rectangular selection tool, it's come in rectangular form, where this free form selection tool will come in irregular shape. Okay, so how it is going to be used we are going to see. So free form selection tool, that it is shown in the, that how it will, it is in the form, is used to select any irregular shape parts of the picture. So it is used to select any, it is an irregular shape, and it is used to any part of the picture. Okay, to select any part of picture. So for that you have to again click on select button. Okay, selection shapes occur, menu occur, in that you will get a rectangular selection. Below that there is a free form selection tool, so you have to select the free form selection tool. Okay, so yeah, select the free form selection tools. Now see here that after clicking selection shapes will occur. In that rectangular selection is there, free form selection is there, so you have to select on free form selection. Okay, after selecting this free form selection, place the pointer on a drawing area. So which part of the drawing you want to cut or you want to move, okay, you have to place the pointer on that drawing, on that drawing area. Okay, now here we have selected the ear of a Mickey Mouse. Okay, what we have selected? The ear of Mickey Mouse. Select the object by holding down left mouse button and move pointer around the outer boundary of the object. So you have to select the part of any picture. So what you do, you have to select that part by holding the right mouse button and moving pointer around the outer boundary of the object. Till outer boundary you have to select that part, that which you want to move. Okay, then see here, we have select free form selection tool. Now see how it will occur. See, we are moving the ear of the mouse. So see here, in which shape it is? It is in irregular shape. You can define it whether it is a square, circle, or rectangle, or triangle. No, it is irregular in shape. Got it? How it will be occur? Okay, how it will be look if you draw on the pictures like this, it will look. Okay, it is in irregular shape. Then release the mouse object button. Release the mouse object button and select the object. After selecting the object, once you select that area you want to move, just release the mouse button. Drag the ear toward right as shown in figure. Okay, now after you have selected that portion of the picture, you can move in air any, you can move anywhere. Okay, whether right or left, here we have move toward the right area. Okay, so see, it will look like this. See, we have moved this area. Got it? Like this it will, see that we are moving that, the ear of that ear of the Mickey Mouse. Okay, we have seen that how it will be selected. After selecting, how it will be move? It will move like this. So drag the ear toward right as shown in figure. Now click on undo button
So it is shown how undo button is seeing there. So if you click on like this button undo and observe the changes, what will happen if you click on the undo button? It will come in its original form. Okay, it will come in its original form. Try this, you will know what changes will occur. Okay, after we move the ear, okay, now it will get separate from the drawing. Okay, the ear part is get separate from the face of the Mickey Mouse. Once you click on undo button, this button, you will observe the changes. What will happen? You will see the same picture, that ear, the ear of the mouse, Mickey Mouse, is connected to the original picture. Means original picture will come. Okay, got it? The difference between the regular selection tools and freeform selection tools, that rectangular selection tools and freeform selection tools. In rectangular shape will occur, and in freeform selection tool, irregular shape, it has no shape, irregular shape will occur. Okay, to select the object or a drawing, to select any pictures or drawing. Got it now? Okay, so in today's class we have learned more about MS Paint. We learn about what is MS Paint. It is a simple graphic program, is used to draw pictures on the screen and paint them with different color. We also see the more tools of the MS Paint. Okay, like selection, we have used today select tools. By using select tools, we see what is the use of rectangular selection tools. By using this rectangular selection tools, we can move any selected portion of a drawing. We can move with the help of rectangular selection tools. Okay, then we have seen the firm form selection tools. We have seen free form selection tools. What is free form selection tools? It is a irregular shape. You can select any pictures or drawing by using irregular shapes, and you can move that. Yes, you can move that shape on the screen. So we have also seen the difference between the rectangular selection and free form selection. In rectangular selection, it occurs in rectangular shape, and in free form selection tools, we see it come in irregular shape. The portion we will select, we have selecting the any part of pictures. Okay, we can move with the help of this. We can move with the help of these tools. Okay, till this we have learned. Now we are going to learn more about MS Paint in the next class. Till then, you have to revise all this thing we have learned today. Okay, so we will see you in next class. Till then, take care.